Hey guys, Sifu Jason here with the greatest boxer you probably never heard of, unless you're really a boxing geek like I am. The book review, okay? And it is Gene Tunney. Greatest boxer you probably never heard of, book review. The book obviously has Tunney, and it goes to show you how famous Jack Dempsey was, in that Tunney's career is defined by the fact that he beat Dempsey twice. And half of this book is really about Dempsey. So if you've never read it, I recommend it highly to you. It gives you tremendous background in you know, early 20th century history. And again, it's just fascinating. So I love reading about the great boxers and the great warriors of old. And I love history. So I heartily recommend this book to you. A couple of things about it. Number one, if you don't know who Gene Tunney was the great light heavyweight that moved up in 1926 and beats Jack Dempsey, who was a reigning world heavyweight champion. And people were afraid that Jack, of course, was going to kill Gene, but Gene puts on a boxing clinic. And if you've seen the footage of the long count, which was the second fight, which was rematched in 27 in Chicago. Well, the thing about that what you see is that Tunney does go down because Dempsey battles him, catches him, battles him down. And there was a long count. And because Jack didn't go to the right corner, didn't go to a neutral corner. He was used to his old rules of just hovering, waiting for the guy to get up and bashing him like he did against Willard in 19 in Toledo. But in this case, he's got to get to a neutral corner, so that delays the count. I do believe Tunney could have gotten up by the count of 10. And then he gets up and you see him running. And people attribute that to Gene Tunney, that like, Tunney was running from Dempsey. That is not the way the fight went. They fought two 10-round fights. They fought 10 rounds, not 15, because Jack hadn't really fought since 1923 in the Furpo fight. He's been making movies and living like the heavyweight champion of the world. So they didn't want him to go too far. They didn't want him to go too long. So that wasn't to protect Tunney. It was actually to protect Jack. Well, Gene had mastered the hit and not get hit style, which made him unpopular. The great Will Rogers didn't like Gene Tunney because Gene Tunney was very well read. He sat around reading Shakespeare and you know, great literature. And I was going to say Hemingway, but Hemingway didn't have any great books out at that point. Nobody knew who he was until the following year. But anyway, in the case, Tunney was so well read that even Will Rogers said, "I want my heavyweight champion to be bigger on the punch and less in the books," or something like that. So it goes to show you that cut your ear off and you're going to get a crowd. I mean, there's even some guys on YouTube and they're very bombastic and they're going to get a bigger crowd than, you know, someone that's going to be a bit more respectful. That's just the way it goes. So, you know, my thought is that if I was a person who was screaming all the time and dropping F-bombs, we'd have a different type of crowd here. Gene Tunney was that kind of gentleman, and he was very articulate. He was very, very, very smart, and he developed a style that was very powerful, and I think it's very JKD-ish. You know, when you look at classic boxing, the way Gene would move, bang, he'd use a heavy jab, and he had a very heavy right hand. He hits Jack really hard early in the fight. Jack doesn't really remember too much of the first fight because Gene clobbered him. He was not running. He was a power boxer. He was a very smart boxer who fought with a lot of leverage and power. Don't forget in the long count fight, incidentally, another defense of Gene is that Gene knocked Jack down the next round. And Gene dominated of the 20 rounds they fought, dominated 19 of them, except for the one round he got knocked down. More about his background. He was a Marine. He grew up in New York City. Mom wanted him to go into the priesthood or something like that. He's sitting at the table one day after a fight against his mother's wishes. And his father didn't want him to do that either because he didn't want his mother to be mad at him. So he's scruffed up a little bit, and his mother is hysterical, and she says, "What are you doing? What are you doing fighting? What are you doing fighting?" And Gene apologizes. His dad works as a stevedore, I think it was, in New York, and you know, dangerous jobs. Around that time, 1913, 1914, in New York City, for every four men, there were like five women, because that many men were dying at work, because work was very dangerous. So Gene said, "Well, okay, I'm sorry," and he puts the money he made from the fight on the table, $40. I mean, that's what his dad made all month working a really hard job. So his dad goes, when's your next fight? And Gene was off to races. So he goes into Marine Corps World War I, and he's considered a fighting Marine. He becomes the you know, kind of like the wartime boxing champion. He comes out. He has an incredible career. He beats Battle Levinsky for the light heavyweight title. And then he beats Harry Greb. He fought him five times. He lost the first fight in a tough fight. Greb was considered a Pittsburgh windmill. No one wanted to fight him. Jack Dempsey even threw Greb, the middleweight, out of his training camp because Greb was so difficult to deal with. He was constantly in motion, swinging, and unfortunately, there's no footage of Greb fighting, but everyone said that he was a dynamo. It was like getting into a fight with a tornado. And Tunney got mauled the first fight, and then he's in the hospital for a while after that from all the injuries he had, because Harry Greb would come up with a jab, a headbutt, a forearm, a right hand, a low blow, kicking the shin. He was, a dirty infighter with a lot of defense because he was just always in motion. Well, Tunney kept thinking about the fight and then rematched him four times. In an age where no one wanted to fight Greb once, Tunney fought him four more times after losing that bad of a fight and beat him. One was a no decision, but close fights, but when you rank great fighters, you rank them against other great fighters. When you look at, say, Mike Tyson blew away weaker opposition, but when he ran into Holyfield, Lewis, fighters that were better fighters, he struggled mightily against that. Tunney beats Levinsky, he beats Greb. He also fought Loughran, who was another great, Tommy Loughran, an underrated light heavyweight fighter who really would have won the world heavyweight title, but he ends up running into Carnera, who was, a giant at the time. So Gene Tunney fought the best of his time. He knocked out Tommy Gibbons. He beat Carpentier, knocked him out. And of course, he gets the two fights against Dempsey. So Tunney, great fighter, very smart man. And after he wins the title against Dempsey, he has one world heavyweight title defense. And he knocks that guy out, and then he's sparring for another fight. He has a bad clash of heads. And he's like, he kind of really rings his bell. And he's like, you know what? I'm done. And he retired. And he never came back. He was really good with his money. And, he married a very rich lady from a very rich family. It was apparently true love. Some of his kids went into politics, became senators. You can forgive him for that, but nevertheless, Tunney's family did well. He kept his money. He stayed married. He's just an exemplary example of just a great boxing champion. So I heartily recommend Tunney to you, and you'll get a lot about Dempsey in it because that's just the nature of the beast. You can't talk about the 20s without talking about Jack Dempsey. And, if it's baseball, you're going to hear about Babe Ruth, that kind of thing. But this guy ought to be more well-known. So hopefully, if you haven't, go pick this thing up. And it's just a great, great tour of a great champion pretty much nobody's ever heard of. And I think he's one of the great pound-for-pound boxers of all time. So anyway, hope you liked the book and you enjoyed the video. And, please check us out online. We've got some links to your stuff, books I've written, not about Gene Tunney, but in the links below. And please click the like and subscribe button, and we'll catch you next time.